Now the second question, name each polygon. So the first one is, it has three sides. So it is a triangle. Now the second one is, now it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it has 5 sides. So it is a pentagon. The third one, so it has 8 sides, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It has 8 sides, so it is an octagon. Now let us see the next question. Draw a rough sketch of a regular hexagon. Connect any three of its vertices. Draw a triangle. Identify the type of the triangle you have drawn. So first let us draw the rough sketch of a regular hexagon. So regular hexagon means it has 6 sides. And all the 6 sides are of equal length. So this is a regular hexagon A, B, C, D, E, F. And connect any three of its vertices. So let us connect A to E. And we will connect AC. And we will connect EC. So here AE, AC and EC, the three sides are of equal length. So then we can say that it is an isosceles triangle. So triangle AEC. Now triangle AEC is an equilateral triangle. Cut. So far you have learnt only the two dimensional shapes such as rectangle, square, rhombus, triangle, parallelogram. So these have only the length and breadth, and now we will deal with the three dimensional shapes. Now we can find out so many three dimensional shapes from our day to day life. Now if you see the brick, now it is a three dimensional shape because it has length, breadth and also height. And ice cream cone, and it is conical shape, and cricket ball, so it is round, so then it is considered as a sphere. And powdered tin, so it is in the shape of a cylinder. So these are the different examples of the three dimensional shapes. Now let us see what is a cuboid. Now let us observe a cuboid. It has length, breadth, height are different. Now if you take the cuboid, now this edge is called, this is edge, so this side is called edge, and this side portion, so this is called face. This flat surface is called its face, and where two faces meet each other, so this is called edge. So this face and this, the behind face, so these two faces meet in a line, so this is called the edge of the cuboid. And where two edges meet each other, so this point is called vertex. Now let us see a cuboid. Now this is in the shape of a cuboid. So these lateral surfaces are called faces, and the two faces meet in a line. So this is called the edge of the cuboid, and two edges meet in a point. So this is called vertex of the cuboid. Now if you take any cube, now here also it has faces, so this is edge and it is a vertex. Now let us see a cube. A cube has all the three dimensions same, because the length, breadth and height, all the length, breadth and height are the same. Now the two, so these lateral faces are called faces, and the two faces meet in a line. So this is called edge of the cube, and the two edges will meet in a point. So this point is called vertex of the cube. Now how many faces does a cube have? So let us find the number of faces. So four side faces and the top and bottom. So it has six faces, and the edges four in the top, four in the bottom and four in the sides. So it has 12, 4 plus 4 plus 4, 12 edges, and the vertices 4 in the top and 4 in the bottom. So it has 8 vertices. Now let us see some other 3 dimensional shapes. So a prism. Now a 3 dimensional shape which has triangular bases and the lateral faces are rectangles is called a prism. Now this prism has, the base of this prism is in the shape of a triangle, so it is a triangular prism. If the shape of the base of any prism is a square, then it is called a square prism. And if the base of the base is in the shape of a pentagon, so it is called a pentagonal prism. So the name of the prism depends on the shape of its base. Now next, and in case of, next one is a pyramid, and in a prism the lateral faces are rectangles. Now pyramid. Now here the shape of the base is a triangle, and it has three lateral faces. These three lateral faces are also triangles, will meet in a point. So this type of prism is called a pyramid. So as the base is in the shape of a triangle, it is a triangular pyramid. And if the shape of the base is like a square, then it is said to be a square pyramid. Now this is a square pyramid. Next, cylinder. Now it is also a type of three-dimensional shape, a type of prism. It has two circular bases and the lateral face is like a curve. It has two circular faces and the lateral faces is in the shape of a curve. So then this is called cylinder and a sphere. So sphere means it is also a three-dimensional shape which has all the lateral faces and everything will be in the curve shape. So this is said to be a sphere. Let us solve two problems based on the three dimensional shapes. First one is, name the following figures. So in this first one is, Now this figure is a cuboid. It is a three-dimensional shape which has six lateral faces. Now it is a cube because all the sides are of equal length. So it is a sphere. No, it is a cone. It is a cylinder. Next one. So it is a triangular prism or triangular pyramid because one of the base is in the shape of a triangle and the other base is a vertex. So it is a triangular pyramid. Now the next question, what shape is a brick? A brick is in the shape of a cuboid. And a road roller is in the shape of a cylinder. Next, a sweet laddu is in the shape of a sphere. And an ice cream cup is in the shape of a cone.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.